So by Buffalo Pinball is online, and my friend Tori is streaming for her first time. And what am I doing jumping online? A few things. One, I stumbled onto a new emulator for these really horrible Laserdisc. Actually, this wasn't even Laserdisc. This was a VHS tape. So yeah, I'm gonna be doing the VHS tape. I wanted to show off my really sharp shirt. This is the Pinball Underground, another Twitch streamer that I enjoy. Good folks to hang out with. It's the latest search shirt from Pinball Underground, or not Underground. What am I thinking? Undesirables. I know the difference between an underground and undesirable, but my head just puts them together wrong. What I think that means is I need some beer. Tonight we got Welly's Upside IPA. A bit more hops than I usually like, but what are you going to do? It's one of the sampler packs. They had a beer and cheese special this week. So good. But yeah, and I'll have to share Tori's channel towards the end of this. We'll do a raid for today's her first stream. So I feel like a bit of a heel for, firing up and, doing this. But I was planning on doing this anyway. So anyway, this is the Singe front end. Here's my Action Max games. I had these on the light gun when I was a kid. So it's pretty cool. This is new to me. Somebody made a Laserdisc game of Samurai Jack. That's just beyond cool. I will absolutely be streaming some of that. More Action Max. Space Pirates. Oh, check that out. The Last Bounty Hunter. Time Gal. I may or may not play this. This was actually an arcade game that got a little risque at times. Never actually showed anything, but there's no shortage of clothing being blown away and awkward situations. Of course, I know all this because, I know all this. Who Shot Johnny Rock? So another gun game. Absolutely, I think, worth my time. Let's start up. Where do I want to go? Oh, Conan. Now, this is kind of, because this is the Italian dub. Somebody made a Laserdisc game. And I'm a huge Miyazaki fan. Conan, Boy of the Future, was the first feature-length show, not feature-length, the first regular TV series that Hayao Miyazaki directed. You can see the actions in how Conan moves, and a lot of the direction and the foundation that Miyazaki set for later. Anyway, I'm a huge anime nerd too. Crime Patrol. So let's start with what has to be the cheesiest of them. This
Action Max. A steady aim is critical.
Okay, I put the border around it. Got my light gun out. I'm pretty sure. Let's go standard game. I turned off the cursor, which I found really distracting. I'm going to take off the orange ring because I don't feel like I need that today. So get ready. Let's see where we're at. Oh, Hydro Sub 2021. Look at the VHS quality on this. This is glorious. So where am I going?
I don't read your navigation. Explain.
I can't, Captain. I've never seen anything like it before.
Move aside, mate. Let me look at that. Good Lord. Can it be
true? You need beer for this.
This may be it. The Lost World. Man your battle stations.
Oh, it's the Lost World. Let's go to our battle stations.
We have to be prepared to defend the Sea Dragon against anything. Oh, I've heard many a tale of this accursed place. But I never thought I'd live to see it with my own eyes. And if the tales be true, then we'll be facing the most abominable creatures the gods ever put on this world, or any other. Monsters that are half fish, half machine. metallic crabs is as big as elephants. Indescribable devils that lance rays of deadly energy. But I've also heard tell there are friendly creatures, so find a line of fire and gunny officers. It's up to you.
It's up to you.
If we can't fight our way out, then we'll be lost here forever.
Lost forever.
So, land your weapons.
I got it.
Fire when
ready. Okay, I'm ready. Man, I remember thinking how, I remember playing these and how cheesy it was even on the VHS tape. It was about this accurate back then, too. So, I'm not sure how this game is doing this. But in the original, so what happened is your light gun would read the flickering circles. And they're actually flickering at different frequencies. So there's like good guy and bad guy circles. So I'm not really sure, because this is working more as a mouse. So the mouse is essentially clicking on. And so the mouse is clicking on those circles. Jeez. So bad. I paid money for this. So basically, what the Action Max unit would do is it would just basically count plus or minus if you hit good guys or bad guys. And then you kind of see how high of a score you could get.
All right, you roundies. Hold it down. Worst to come.
Okay. And of course, at the end of the game, you have to rewind the tape. And the red light you see down in the corner of the screen would actually been up on top of the TV, and it was connected to the Action Max unit, and it would light up anytime you got a hit. Because on a videotape, it really can't do any other sort of program at all. There's no alternate stream to it. It's literally just how many times can you shoot the flickering white dots on the screen? Score is 90. Oh, that sub. Gotta have that sub. Thank you. registering anymore. I got that one. Oh no, it got me. Danger, danger. This is better. Man, this makes me think of 70s British sci-fi TV. Of course, this, I think, was mid-80s, so... Get out on deck and man your weapon. Got one. It's the same ones that blow up every time.
Damage control, keep working on those repairs.
Keep working on those repairs. Weird how sometimes it locks right onto it, and other times not. If I remember it, I don't think I paid full price on these. They were like 20 bucks a tape when they first came out, and I got them on clearance for $5. Thinking, what a bargain! Hey, Wax. Have you ever seen an Action Max before? VHS video games, who'd have thought? And here I am, 30 years later, 40 years later, emulating it on my computer. Okay, let's get the bad guys. Yeah, Captain Power. Same thing. Oh, man. Those Captain Power ships was cool. I really liked the way they ejected the action figures out. I had two of them, and you could play head-to-head with the Captain Power toys. So those were better than Action Max. Action Max was just a cheap plastic light gun and a sensor and a VHS tape. But I mean, you gotta admit, this is pretty clever. Thinking they're, making these videos. These little flickering circles on them. And a light gun to pick them up. Best. Okay. Yeah, the whole series of Captain Power actually were pretty awesome toys. Remember right, they're like 15 minutes long or so. You had to get your money's worth, right? But at the end of the day, I think the real frustration with these VHS-based games is the fact that they just don't change at all. It's the exact same story every time. And, you know, how many times... It's not like the story's compelling. It's like, oh, look, there's little dots floating across the screen. And I think a lot of it is the immersion that is missing. Because it's like, you know, all I'm really doing is counting up numbers. I don't actually get to blow up anything. I'm sure they blow up. They blow up if I shoot it or not. So, this was a neat thing to have, a neat moment in time. Not surprised it didn't catch on. I have a little bit of nostalgia. I'm not going to sit through the whole thing. So that was Action Max. That was 1987. Wow, I thought it was earlier than that. But there's Pops Ghostly, which again is little floating circles to shoot at. I'll come back to Samurai Jack. Now, Space Pirates is actually an arcade Laserdisc game. So I'm expecting a bit more pizzazz from it. The Laserdiscs, what was really cool with these and where it's indexing it, is they could go to exact time codes very quickly. So, so anyway, with them, first off, they broke down like nobody's business. Anybody who had one of these Laserdisc games in the arcade,
this is Ursula Skye, commander of Colonial Star One.
We are
under attack. Repeat, under attack. My ship has been overrun by the Black Brigade.
Oh no, the Black Brigade!
Captain Talon is in control of the Star Splitter cannon. They're beaming colonists aboard the Black Dragon as hostages until the cannon crystals are found. Situation bleak. Deflector shield destroyed. Can't hold out much longer. Please respond.
Huh. This actually has slightly better production values than I remember. Look at that early 3D modeling. That's like 1992, I think they said.
Space Pirates!
So.
Alas, a scourge of the galaxy. Captain Talon has invaded our fair homeland.
Oh no, Captain Talon.
Sinister mind has concocted a diabolical plan to exterminate us all.
Exterminate us all? Oh no.
Welcome aboard the Black Dragon! Pay no attention to this lovely but pitiful creature. Any attempt to come to her aid will be met with certain extremity.
Oh, you know I have to go to her aid.
You see this black hole? Was Parallax previous to me? Now I will answer him with his own Star Splitter. This galaxy is mine!
Is.
Who can stop this mad pirate?
Oh no! Who can stop the mad pirate?
As it stands now, it looks as though this malevolent mis-angled armada of cutthroat pirates will succeed.
My greatest creation.
Okay, so Star Splitter.
I want to shoot things.
Talon needs now are the star crystals that will arm it.
Oh, crystal. This is so cheesy.
I've been lost for years on different worlds throughout the solar system. We must find them before Talon.
We gotta find them.
The journey will be treacherous and fraught with danger. There are many foes. Not only will you have to repel
oh, that car's awesome.
A formidable and seemingly invincible.
It looks like they got a whole bunch of Skadians around.
Sorcerers and mystics with their own bag of tricks.
What kind of budget they have.
Star crystals. And of course, there is the greatest nemesis of them all. Captain Talon. I want you to know.
Okay. Orders in.
These pirates are armed to the
Let's play the game. I didn't realize I was watching all promo stuff. So here's the actual game.
Just beyond the asteroid belt. Can you make it?
Can we make it? Hey, I got one.
Nice shoot.
Yep. I don't know if that was good or bad. I gotta be careful.
Energy level is getting critical.
Okay. So. Here we go. Around the corner. First guy jumps out. Shoot him. What?
You're in danger, Star Ranger. Make every shot count.
You gotta be right on the money with this. Apparently not too early, not too late. What did I miss?
Too bad, but I thought you could do it. Why not try again?
Yeah, I'll try again. I'll drop another quarter in. People paid money for this. Okay, you gotta be really fast with it. Really fast. Not fast enough.
Be careful, Ranger. Energy level is getting critical.
Okay, so it's a memorization pattern. So, come around. First guy. Second guy. Third guy. Oh, come on. I was there. No, this is only a one-player game. Not multiplayer at all. Oh, jeez. Oh. Okay. That was painful. Let's see if... Who shot Johnny Rock? Let's see if this is any better. So, and I've turned off the cursor for the game, so I don't know if it's the accuracy of the game or if it's the... So this is tracking... You can't see the cursor, but that's pretty dead accurate. So my cursor is good. So I don't think it's the Sinden. I think it's... these really horrible old games with their split second timing. So let's put some quarters in here and find out. Okay. So 1991.
Someone to see you, boss.
As soon as I saw her,
I knew she was trouble.
I'm in trouble, and I need your help.
Then I made my first mistake. I said I'd listen.
Telegram for you, boss.
Oh, seriously?
Cheese.
You remind me of Swiss cheese.
Okay, so the girl comes in.
Someone to see you, boss.
As soon as I saw her, I knew she was trouble.
I'm in trouble, and I need your help.
Then I made my first mistake. I said I'd listen.
Telegram for you, boss.
Someone
Someone shot my boyfriend, Johnny Rock. And I want you to find out who it was.
Johnny Rock. He was a singer. He always wanted to be on the hit parade. And that night, somebody made his wish come true. When I got to Johnny Rock, I found this in his hand.
Johnny, are you there? Johnny, what's the lucky number?
What's the lucky number?
Johnny and I. You can call me Red. We were going to be married. Johnny had the goods on somebody, and I want you to find them.
I asked if she was being done a date and gives you roses.
The key to the mystery will be found in Johnny's safe.
No money? Take him to the morgue.
You make a good stiff. A bad shot, but a good stiff.
Oh, we gotta continue that. Wow.
The key to the mystery will be found in Johnny's safe.
Nail the rat that did this. Put him away until he's as old and gray as the cement in his cell.
Then I made my second mistake. I said I'd try.
I'll try.
Then I opened the telegram.
Cat's Eye Detective Agency. Do not kill the suspects. Joey Ray.
There are too many suspicious thugs hanging around the office. You better not come back here anymore.
Shoot, where you want to go? Oh, well, let's go to the pool hall.
I walked into a room of sharks.
Hey, bud, this is a private club.
I told him I was looking for mumps.
Yeah, well, I ain't looking for you. I'll store you in my cheeks till winter.
Take care of him,
boys.
Oh, that was awesome.
Patching you up anymore is like patching up a sieve.
I gotta see that again. Just watch the guy jump up onto the pool table as he gets shot. I mean, that's absolutely priceless. Okay, back to the pool hall. Okay. We're gonna go talk to Mumps.
I walked into a room of sharks.
Hey, bud, this is a private club.
I told him I was looking for Mumps.
Yeah, well, I ain't looking for you. I'll store you in my cheeks till winter. Take care of him, boys.
Do I play that again? I mean, that was... It was entertaining, but not for the right reasons. So, 1991. Oh, not what I wanted to do. I'm going to load the... Okay, back out of there. So, there's another Action Max game, 38 Ambush Alley. Not going to play any more of those. I think I'll probably just end up clearing that off. Crime Patrol. You know what? I'm gonna put the light gun away. Now, I've been trying to figure out how to reconfigure this to map to one of my buttons. And the joystick is working fine. I got the joystick set. I got the coins and the quarters. But, yeah, so I can put quarters in. I can hit the one player start. But I gotta use my keyboard to do the directions. Now, I've only just tested this to make sure I had the control, so let's see what happens. Oh, I love Samurai Jack. So this is essentially Dragon's Lair, but with Samurai Jack. Okay, so I see. So when it says action, that means I have to do the button and the joystick at the same time. So, and it only gives you a split second, so there's a lot of memorization. Or very fast reflexes. Too slow. Two, one. For a fan-made game, this is pretty awesome. Oh, I've missed the button. So it's down and the button. That horse is amazing. Oh, you got, for the power, you gotta hold down on the button. Well, good thing I can have quarters to put in there. I like that it doesn't make me work through the whole thing again. Just, you know, recover with what I did. No joystick that time. Do it over again. Sword fight time. Ah, I missed the joystick direction on that one. Okay. Too slow again. I think I'm just about, oh, still in. No, that's it. So, anyway, Singe, S-I-N-G-E, is available free. They've got all these games for free. Light gun games, Laserdisc games. It's all abandonware or fan-made stuff. The American Laserdisc people are gone. And so, you know, this Betson Pacific, it does, wow. So yeah, it says here American Laser Games. So American Laser Games is gone, and I believe that the owner of the rights even pointed out that, you know, hey, if you want to use this stuff, share it. So that's what's happening, and this is a hoot. Time Gal, I'm pretty sure is not an American Laserdisc game. But again, I don't see anybody chasing after the rights on that. If you want to see any of these, there are YouTube videos for people doing the full playthrough on all of them. If you're ever in the mood for the classic Laserdisc-style game, these are a lot of fun. Okay. So, let's shut that down. I'm going to stop that. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to change my monitors around here. So what I need to do is I'm As I said in my intro on the screen, I want to play the FX3 tournament. So now if I go from there, I go to FX3. Let me double check. And somehow my playfield and backlash screens got mixed up. I'm going to take just a moment while this is loading to swap them around the right way. Okay. Yeah, I know. It's sideways. I don't care at this point. Let's take a look at the tournaments. So the Tandy Gab is the Funhouse one that I did. Oh, I still have 4 attempts left. So let's see. So I'm down here in 7th place now. So my 15 million. Let's see if I can bump 20 million. Wow, Pinstat's Dan is only 5th. That kind of surprises me. So let's see where I go. I've got 4 attempts left. View I want. Ah, so bouncy. Yeah, so you're right. Those laser games, you could see those cabinets being reused. The Space Ace cabinets were pretty cool, actually. I always kind of liked seeing the games that got stuffed into those. And honestly, in my head right now, all I'm thinking about is how this looks really horrible sideways, and I'm trying to think of what I could do to change it. There's not much. Not without just stopping the stream and restarting it. I will point out that the Singe... so it's interesting. So Singe is actually named after the dragon from Dragon's Lair. If you ever played Dragon's Lair 2, it was Escape from Singe's Castle. So that when people were making the system, they called it Singe, S-I-N-G-E. let's burn up my last few attempts. My heart's not in this. I got a little bit of the shake worked into that. Didn't realize my shift buttons were so sensitive. Yeah. But you know what? For commercial, easy to set up game systems, FX3 is currently the best of the commercially available pinball games. VPX has more oomph to it, and definitely, I'm gonna say, the ability to have better games. But for what this is, and you know, knowing how broad the hardware is that they have to design for, FX3 is actually pretty good. I don't think it's 600 for all the games. They got bundles and packs all the time. But, you know, for the number of games and the amount of hours of coding that go into this, I mean, there's over 100 different Zen games now. You know, not to mention the licensing. So they've got their, they've announced the Mandalorian game coming out. So I know people can't get enough of that stupid baby Yoda. Ugh, look at that. So as a whole, I've got generally favorable things to say about Zen. It would be nice if there was a commercial product that had the depth of features that Visual Pinball provides. I personally feel that Star Wars is a bit overrated. I mean, I've been to every movie within a week of opening day, most of them on opening day. But you could feel it in, it was a little bit heavy-handed at first in Return of the Jedi, where, you know, you throw in these improbable Ewoks as the cute and cuddly toys. And you get the real sense that, you know, Star Wars was about merchandising toys at that point. You know, Episode 4 changed sci-fi, adventure, you know, I mean, it was revolutionary. You know, I don't think anybody ever expected it to become the phenomena that it turned into. But, yeah, Empire Strikes Back was a glorious tribute to the old serials. You know, and the ambiguity of the ending, you know, it's like, oh my goodness, what's going to happen and where is this going? And, you know, there's like those soap opera elements to it. But then it just became predictable, repetitious. You know, it's like, okay, we're gonna have some lightsaber fights, and we're, you know, it's more about saying, hey, remember this thing you liked? Here's this thing you liked. Well, let's have some more of that. And I think why The Mandalorian works is it's really going back and making old Western. You know, it's like you get the lone wolf and cub storyline, which when you break down Episode 4, that was just Lucas redoing a Kurosawa movie. You know, so again, you're getting the inspiration back from the Japanese cinema. You know, and I think that's part of why The Mandalorian really works, is it's got that space age take on some really epic Japanese storytelling. Yeah. Well, and I've been, it's interesting because I've been hearing stories about Lucas's wife and how she kind of managed the property, managed the storytelling. He'd want to go do something really stupid, and she's like, you know, if you changed your approach here, or you did this a little bit differently. She, from all sense of things, a big part of the reason why the first two Star Wars movies were so awesome is Lucas's wife. Yeah. And it's funny because we were just playing Samurai Jack, and the Clone Wars that the Samurai Jack team did is some of my favorite Star Wars. I absolutely love watching that animated Clone Wars with all those little bits. See, I liked Rogue One. I thought Solo was absolutely horrible. The problem Solo had was so many of the story elements in it existed 100% to give some fan service. You know, it's like, you know, hey, you know, let's say this, let's make up a story for this thing you know about. It's like, oh, you remember Chewbacca? Well, here's how we met Chewbacca. You know, it's like, oh, his name's Solo? Let's make up a reason why we know his name is Solo. You know, it's like, nobody was asking for that. That doesn't tell any story. It's just like, bah, you know, here's a thing that, you know, people are going to say, hey, that's kind of fun. I know his name's Solo. So, you know, what I'm going to do is I'm going to like that because I now know why his name's Solo. It's like, nah. So, yeah. Anyway, Solo is absolutely my least favorite of all the Star Wars properties. I mean, even the Christmas special had more heart. As horrible as it was. Which I can't, I almost don't want to believe it, but I'm reading that they're doing a Lego remake of, I'm not sure how Solo can get better. You know, the train robbery scene. I love the train robbery scene. I you know, the visuals are solid. You know, it's you know, you got your car chases, but when it comes right down to storytelling, that's where I think Solo just falls apart. So many story elements don't have any reason to be there. It's just like, oh, hey, you know, let's tell another, you know, Han Solo history bit. Yeah, well, in the Skywalker saga, again, you know, there were ideas of things, but the whole story wasn't there. Man, my heart's not even in the pinball. And you're sitting, I can't believe you're still tuned in. You know what? The actors are fine. But, you know, and that's where I kind of, I feel sorry for people like Hayden Christensen, because the dialogue he was given to work with was absolutely juvenile. You know, I'm like, who wrote this stuff? I don't care how good of an actor you are. If you're given dialogue that seems like the first thing that came to the mind of a group of high school students working on a project, you know, it's going to be a bad movie. But Hayden was fine as an actor. I've seen him in other things. He wasn't just Star Wars. He actually can act. I'm just hacking. But even the Mandalorian is kind of guilty of some of that, you know, hey, look, you know, they like to poke at this, you know, your Star Wars history, right? You know, hey, here's this little bit of a... Give me the shot at it. I don't think I get another shot here. Hello. Oh, that's rude. Ha! I'm having my first decent game, and it's like... Nah, you know what? You're doing good now. So, we're just gonna reset here. Okay.
Game paused.
It's not paused, it dumped out on me. Wow. So, I always knew there were code problems. You know, in the real Funhouse, I've hit reset similar to this. I didn't realize they would copy that part of the code over as well without massaging it. And what's interesting is because of the front end on it...
Game paused.
I can't do much. I know, I'm gonna lose my progress. Okay, so I really think I should get back to light gun games. So I'm going to change my display settings here real quickly. And we're going to save that one. Make this my main display. Good, it's up there. What was I playing with the other day that was pretty awesome? So let me close this, which screen's up now. not change. Go there, back here again. I don't know what I'm doing with this stuff anymore. But I do like arguing about movies. That kind of makes me happy. Because I don't know if you can tell or not, but I have definite feelings. and it's, what's funny is, while I pick apart movies and the stories, I will still sit and enjoy that whole train robbery scene in Solo. I mean, it's a roller coaster ride. There's no substance at all, but man, what a great ride that is. You know. Oh, I know what I'm gonna play. If I can get this with. Let's see how this keeps going. Mad Bullets. The question is, do I have this configured properly? Ooh, we're loud. Oh, come on. Okay, that's not good. So here. Think. Okay, good. So I've got that set up right. Hey, and I've got my, okay. So I'm back to playing games at least that I can share. So that's good news. Let's try this again. Let me make sure my cursor offset's looking good. That's looking good. And let's fire this bad boy up again. Okay. Oh, that was not good. Not good again. This is gonna be a short round. Okay, so let's see what my, so we'll get my goodies, and we'll check out what the goals are. So, I have to avoid shooting item boxes for 2 minutes, which means I'm not going to be collecting 50 sacks in a round. Well, let's see if I can do 20 headshots in that. So let's go back and see where we're at. So we'll retry, and no boxes this time. So all I'm shooting is bad guys.
Your fire.
And chickens.
Help! I love you.
I'm not getting my head shot. I think think I like the box. I can show the self-control to not shoot those boxes. You know, for the $3 this game costs, this is a lot of fun. El Dingero. Okay, so boxes are done, so now it's on to the bags. Shoot 100 enemies. 71. So wait, did I make my goal? Okay, so I gotta get 50 sacks in a row. Avoid injuries for 5 minutes? No way. Ha! 5 whole minutes without getting hurt. I'm more likely to do the headshots in that time. Okay, let's see where we go. Retry. Oh, Jeez, I didn't even see that one coming in. 15 bags. And they want me to get... Okay. Okay. So the goals I've got... Okay, so I only have to shoot 100 enemies total, not all in one round, so that's good. 20 headshots in a minute. Let's see what we got. So either way, I can keep working on those. Okay, retry. I kind of like the music, actually. And I do see the Skrillex kind of influence you're talking about. I saw the big head and I'm like, oh, I'll just shoot the big headed guy. Let's see where this goes. Oh, we want the death. Vulture Necropolis. Bombs. Okay. So how am I doing? 88. So I got 12 more to get my next goal. And I think I'll definitely do that. And then we'll call that a night. Ain't nobody innocent in this town, ma'am. Wicked rocks.
Get the hell.
Get the hell.
Question mark. Ninja style. I am ninja. Stupid ninjas. Ah, I had 38 bags that time. That's not bad. What do we have here? 10 power-ups. 50 sacks in a row. I did 38 that time. That was pretty good. The headshots, I don't know how to do that. 5 minutes, no way. But come on. Without it. There we go. Whew. So anyway, for $3, that is one heck of a game. I enjoy the overall lightheartedness of it. The even though it's the same street over and over again, it's a random enough event that it feels fresh every time I do a walk through it. What am I going to play for my last game? Let's see what we got here. Something. Let's sort this by year. Fun Cube 5 is not fun, it lies. Turkey Hunting USA from 2001. It says it's yellow, so what are the chances it might work? Let's find out. Oh, so I've got here, this I can change. Crosshair options. We will say off. And I think I'm still in joystick gun 1, so that's all good. So I'm not going to bother changing that. Now, I also realized that I'm still set up for the full widescreen, so this probably is going to give me some... Okay, so obviously my input is not what I thought it was. So let's... Gun 6 today. Okay, that's good to know. Where There's my Y. Okay, everything else is good. Let's go Florida, I guess. Oh, what do I want to shoot? Let's do my 12 gauge. Compound. Okay. You know what? I'm going to have to do this real quickly. It does look like it's actually working. But what I have to do is my cursor offset. So MAME is actually really smart with how it takes the gun input and takes raw input. Whereas with the Mad Bullets, I had to calibrate for my three screens. So anyway, I forgot to make that change earlier. Tell me it didn't change. Okay, that's good. So gun 6. Got a cock first. Okay. Good to know. Sure, why not? Compound bow. Barrel length. Let's see where this takes me. If I can even do this with the compound bow. Hunter, 1, here. Bow. I see. All right, keep going. Hunter 1 here. Don't shoot the hens. Good to know. Shoot a hen, lose a life. I'll try again. Try again. There, I got Tom. Hey, at least I didn't fail out. I'm gonna keep going. Just don't shoot the hens. So it shoots a little high. So I just gotta remember to aim a little lower. I could see at a bar how this would do well. You know, you can sit and have your buddy there, a couple beers. Don't shoot the hens. Just like that, I'm out of beer. Oh yeah, we'll continue that. Bonus stage. Get ready. Bonus stage. Okay. High. Just missed it.
Expert or beginner?
Oh, let's go beginner. That's really a lot high. Ah, I thought I had that one. Okay, and it's like a good distance above where I've been aiming too, so I've got a better sense of where I'm shooting. I bet you there's a calibration menu for the game too. But I don't think I'm really that invested in this. Where are you at? That's a hen.
Don't shoot the hen, knucklehead.
Knucklehead? Grade F. Try it again. Oh, come on. It's definitely shooting high. I like all the stats they go in on the spur and the weight and the age, and I mean there's a lot to it. They put a lot of thought into this game. I was sure I had a Tom there. Final stage. Oh, okay. That's the final stage. So look at all those potential toms in there. That's season's end, March 14th. Final result. 8. So 10 hits, 25 misses. Grade D. I passed. Ha ha. I get to go on to the next grade. So Turkey Hunting USA. Okay, so this is going to be a hard thing because. See if I can do this. I'm literally aiming at the bottom of the W there. So if I aim at the bottom of the 1, so Florida wild turkey. Thank you. See if it gives me a calibration mode here. And so gun menu. Start button to choose, gun trigger to enter. Shoot the center mark only. There we go. So now that it's calibrated, so that is one nice thing. It's like, oh, come on, we can do this. I'm going to change the dip switches back. Yeah, I'll keep the pump action there. Now let's see if it keeps that calibration. That'll be nice.
How many hunters today?
That's better. Let's go out to Montana in the springtime. And we'll do the 12 gauge. Four shots. Let's see what this is like. Calibrated gun. One shot. Now there were three toms there. I only shot the one. So what I've got to remember to do is to line up additional toms. B grade. One shot, one kill. That's worth something. Three shots, two kill. That's what kind of grade that gives me. Still C grade. I guess using the 12 gauge makes it a little easier for me. There we go. My first A. So it's a lot easier when the gun's calibrated, by the way. Ah, shot the hens. So I'm leading the turkey and the screen's panning at the same time. So it's a weird combination of leading your shot at the same time you're being led. Keep going.
You are a turkey slayer.
I'm a turkey slayer. Make me my turkey sandwich of justice. Which, on YouTube, if you haven't seen it, look it up. Turkey Sandwich for Justice. It's become a Thanksgiving regular, for a tradition for my family, actually. It's interesting how a YouTube video can become part of a family tradition. So I'm not sure why this gets the yellow flag. I wonder if it's because... I wonder if it's because nobody's tried it with the proper light gun before. Oh, is that game over? Nah, I'm not going to try again. Still got a bonus stage, though. Maybe that's what's not working about it. Okay, shoot the redheads. Better luck next. Oh, I was one shy. All I had to do is that last one. Let's see what expert looks like here. Betcha I shoot a hen. Nope. I have a turkey score. That's on the expert level I gotta be. I'm good with that. Two more stops. Shot a hen. I'm a knucklehead. DF. Oh. Final stage.
You are Turkish player.
What an interesting game. Season's end. Final result. C? Okay. Copyright. My grade is copyright. I guess I get to put my name up again. No? Oh, wait. A little up and to the left, but not bad. Oh. End it. So, Florida Wild Turkey. Yeah, I could see playing this for a while. So, Turkey Hunting USA. That was interesting. So, a lot of grayed out. The Touchmaster game. Silent Scopes I know don't work. A lot of people have been asking about that. I don't know what Hammer is. Let's make Hammer my last game. Whoa. And Amiro. Don't even know what this is. Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hit me to start. Let's see. Oh, that's right. The input. So. This is one of the things that's frustrating is the USB inputs. I haven't locked them down yet. So. See if I can do this. Oh, it's the mouse. Hit the mouse to qualify.
Ready! Go!
Oh, that's rude! How did I do? 36. I think I only need 18. Cool. What a weird game. Take the action, take the prize. Congratulations. What's my prize? What do I get? What do I get? I get this. Closing credits. Game over. Whoa. That was a buck a game. Okay, mosquitoes. I really hate some mosquitoes. 22 mosquitoes, gotta go. I'll protect the dog from the mosquitoes. Again, so I got two lives. I guess this is where the game doesn't work right. Take the action, take the prize. No prize this time, and it goes right to the closing credits. That's really interesting. Okay, so the game absolutely is not working right, but what a bizarre game. Oh, cockroaches. Okay, this will be the last one. I have 14 cockroaches. It's kind of fun. I like the cartoony aspect of it. Okay, that was kind of fun. So as goofy as this game is, I will likely play this again. This is called Hammer. It's from the year 2000. Turn of the millennium. And this is what we had to play. And that's Hammer from Andamiro. Interesting. So here's the Deer Hunting USA games from Sammy. Those are a lot like the Turkey Hunt. Born to Fight. I don't even think that. It says it's a light gun game. Let's turn off my crosshair. And we're going to go to my input. And I'm going to say player one button. Oh, wait. Let's get the border up. So player one button. Okay. Player two button, or button two. And X analog. Y analog. There's that. Track. Wow. Yeah, I'm just, let's leave this. Let's see what the rest of this does. Born to Fight.
You are starting the mission, Bar to Kill.
Oh, I thought I'd turn that off. It's funny because it does lag, the cursor itself lags behind. Fisherman doing there? This is a hoot of a game. Okay, I'll leave the... Yeah, I get it. You're taking a picture. Oh. Interesting. Yeah, I guess Cabal's a good comparison to that.
Sorry, but you are a dead
hero. Try again. Born to Fight. I don't know what year that really came out. Wow. Let's start easy on this one. I want to be the robot. This can't. Let's see what Europe gives me. Select stage. Sure, we'll try the hoops, I think. I'm not sure what the hoops are for. Make your arrow through all three rings to hit the targets. Zero targets. I don't even know what I'm shooting at here. Okay, shoot the targets, get the score. I can do that. Yeah, I don't know what you're supposed to do here. So there's like a reload that I'm missing somewhere. Did I miss an input? So there's button one. Analog, yeah, there's that. Player two. What a horrible game. it shoots just a little to the left. I really don't know what you're supposed to do here. You're supposed to shoot off to the frame? Is there... That's a horrible game. 0.2, not getting played again. Of course, I'll forget that, and then a year from now, I'll play it again and say, what a horrible game. And I'll repeat over and over again. Let's see if Point Blank 2 works. Oh. Derp. Okay. Everything else is good. Oh no, it's not good. I don't want the targets. Crosshair options. Go away. Okay, I will consider myself a beginner. This is not working right. Shoot the criminals. No limit of bullets. So I never at all assigned. So I didn't. Hold on a second. What's going on with the input on this machine? Okay, that should make things a little different. Okay. Bullet didn't. The. Shoot the target, 25 hits, no time limit, 5 seconds. How'd I do? Oof. Yeah, Point Blank, thrilled to death. What a great series. Point zero, don't do it. Okay, so I gotta shoot the knight's armor off. Ha! And I did that without hitting him. It was 100% hit rate. I'm good with that. That feels like it was earned. Okay, shoot the birds, not the bombs. Bombs are bad. Weird, there's like a little lag on that one. I've not encountered a lag on a level before. I don't know if there's something going on. Let's see what happens on my next level. Target shooting, 420 points. I should be able to do this. If there's any accuracy at all of this, we'll be good. So it was shooting down and to the left just a little bit, but you know, let's see what we got. Ninjas. 18 criminals. Let's take them out. Not bad. I only had to do 18. Oof, it's 10 o'clock already. Keep the sharks away. Here, shark, 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 shark. Glad they blow up so nice. No muss even. Well, they took it easy on me there. Totally missed one. They should have got me. Okay, do the insane one. What do I have to do with the insane level? Shoot 10 identical to the examples. So I have to do, oh man, this is not good. I get it. Okay, so I caught on a little too late. No, I'm not using CRT. This is a Sinden light gun. These are like brand new on the market. This is one of the first 100 beta units. This is you see the white border around the video. So there's a camera in the light gun that uses that border for reference, and it's actually quite accurate and a lot of fun. Calibration on this particular game is just a little to the left and down, but yeah, if you look up some of my previous, yeah, so I backed one on Kickstarter when they first came out, and I said, wow, you know what, these things look like they could be good, but they're kind of pricey, so I only backed one. Well, after my first day of playing around with it, I ordered a second. I'm super impressed with how this works. So you can see how fast it responds. Right now it is shooting to the left just a little bit. I'm sitting here waiting for something to happen, and I like blew away my first 3 seconds of game time. My bad. But I got another life, so I like these. So, shoot the red targets, nice and easy. 28 and 20 seconds. How'd I do? Woo! Crushed it. Yeah, so I could, if I wanted to take some time, I could absolutely recalibrate. Because I'm just playing around right now, I'm just using the raw calibration that it gives me. But yeah, you can sit and tweak these just like you could a real arcade game where the calibration can be recentered. And it's awesome with how accurate it is. And you can see, even with it being just a little off center, I adjust fairly easily and can hit it. These insane levels always kick my butt. Even when it is dead on, I'm kind of weak with them. So shoot the fireworks. Here we go. Yeah, that was kind of sad. Again, a lot of that was just me being bad at it. Okay, so we've got one bad guy and a crowd of good guys. I got one shot. Remember, off to the left, just a little bit. I should be able to do this. See? One shot. Yeah, the Point Blank series really is fantastic. Yeah, so, and absolutely, my back glass is 16.9. What's really cool, because I got it on the ground floor, when the developer first made this, it was made for only a single monitor, but he's worked with me to be able to get it to work with my pinball machine. So... bomb. Oh, this is gonna break my heart. You know, I think I'm done here with Point Blank, I'm gonna go back and do Mad Bullets, which I did earlier. Yeah, no, this is, it's really nice, because I've tried the aim tracks, I've tried the Wii guns, I tried some janky thing that I played while I was in Singapore, so anyway, I'm going to close off MAME here. MAME is the easiest of the games to set up. I have figured out how to handle my aspect ratio. Because I got three monitors, I had to basically do a bit of math and come up to 37.5%. So that's the center screen. So it's not quite 33% because the aspect ratio of my DMD screen is a little off. So that's where I came up with 37.5% being the just the center screen, which is important when I play a PC-based game like Mad Bullets here. So I love Mad Bullets. This game's $3 on Steam, and I just don't get tired of this. Because it is wicked accurate. Ton to shoot in it.
I'll give it to anything.
Wicked rocks.
Yeah.
Oh, let's go mystery. Goon Village. Shot the lady. So anyway. Come on, get it. And here's the goals. So I got one power up. And I can keep building on the power ups. 15 around. I actually did, 38 I think. So that's pretty good there. 10 head, 25 shots a minute. Nope, not going to happen. But come on. I take the border away and exit the game. There we go. So, anyway, it's past my bedtime. Thanks for tuning in. Hope everybody has still healthy and having a good time getting to play some games of your own. Anyway, we'll see you next time.